two friends. As close as brothers. Until war forced them continents apart.
Rebecca Yeldon, one of the producers, handed me the hardcover of the book in 2003 and expressed her love and passion for the book, and I read it at the time. At the time, the book hasn't, you know, at that point, 2003, the book didn't sell 8 million copies. so it was like, basically, I just read it and I loved it, but I thought, how do we get that made? You know, it's the first time I read a story and where Hollywood is willing to make a movie out of, which the first contact is a family story. It's a motion, beautiful family story. It's not, the characters are not terrorists, they're not being villainized or stereotypes. It's just a very simple, beautiful story about that part of the world. And I haven't seen that before, and I thought it was really crucial to make this as a film and tell this story, because it really lends a human face to Afghanistan. And it's a country that's been voiceless and faceless for the last 30 years. And I felt like it really humanized that part of the world.
My son,
the college graduate.
You should come home.
Forgive me for what I have to tell you. Hassan is dead.
A week before he died, he sent you a letter.
Now, to rescue his friend's son.
What happened to the boy?
The Taliban took him.
He must journey to a land he no longer knows.
We need to go back to Kabul.
No, there haven't been any negative reactions so far. You know, we screened the films for several African communities in the U.S. and the African ambassador, and everybody really embraced the film, feels it's a love letter to Afghanistan. It was really literally from the studio that wanted to make sure that the boys are safe. If there would be a reaction in Afghanistan, which would be unexpected, to make sure that the boys are out of the country during the release of the film and see what happens once the film is out, and if there are any reactions.
This fall.
So what brings you back to Afghanistan?
I'm going to find a boy. His father meant a lot to me.
One of the most beloved stories of our time.
Now there is a way to be good again.
Becomes one of the most anticipated films of the year.
You know what they will do to you if they see your clean shaving.
I think, you know, casting Daniel Craig gave an incredible humanity to Bond, and an emotional background to Bond. And I think it's that was the right decision and the right way to explore the character further. And that what really interests me. It's about exploring that journey further. And I think it's really great. I just think that Dan Bradley is a really gifted man. I think what all the films he did and what he brought to all the different action films he had been worked on is really highly creative and very different. And I think it was important, and I really love his taste and I love his ideas. And it was important for me to collaborate with someone who is as creative and has such an interesting approach to action than he does.
From the director of Finding Neverland and Monsters Ball.
I dream that my son will grow up to be a good person. A free person. I dream that someday you will return to revisit the land of our childhood. I dream that flowers will bloom in the streets again. And kites will fly in the skies.